Hello students, welcome back. Myself Pushpendra Singh, and we are going to start with our daily current affairs. So today you have 9th of April 2021. All right, and these lectures are basically useful for those students who are preparing for the civil services examination conducted by the UPSC as well as other government competitive examinations. All right, so for that purpose, you have to read your current affairs, right? Because there are many questions which are asked in the examination from the current affairs portion. And for that purpose, you have to read the national newspapers, like you can read Hindu, The Hindu or Indian Express. Both of these newspapers are equally good. You can refer any of these newspapers. Okay, and these lectures are based on the current affairs. So you can subscribe our channel on the YouTube, okay, where you will get the current affairs lectures on the day-to-day basis. All right, so let's begin with the lecture for the 9th of April 2021. Okay, so first is basically the regarding about the coronavirus. Okay, so here the mutation of the coronavirus is getting in India, right? So this mutant virus, right, which is also a coronavirus, have been found in the genome of various, you know, coronavirus genomes in India. So first of all, let us understand what is this mutation is all about. Okay, when you say the mutation is nothing but the alteration, okay, in the nucleotide. Okay, the alteration in the nucleotide of the virus. Okay, whenever you see there is an alteration, so which means there is an alteration in the nucleotide of the virus. Okay, why this alteration will be happens? This alteration will be happened sometime naturally, or sometime it is, you know, man-made, that happens in the laboratories also. Okay, so that is a mutation, and the mutant virus have been found in India also. Okay, so double mutant virus which have been found in India have been, you know, bearing the spread, right, of the coronavirus, which have been, you know, fourth wave, which is basically spreading in India currently. Okay, so currently, the formal classification for this, the mutant virus have been found, is V.1.617. So this is what is basically, you know, the mutant or the mutation of the virus which have been named, right, formally. Okay, so when you say the mutation, so as I told you, the mutation is basically nothing but, right, the alteration in the nucleotide sequence of the genome of an organism that may have your virus, or that may have some sort of a extra chromosomal DNA. So it is a alteration. It is an alteration in the nucleotide sequence of a genome. Okay. Now, this variant, which is common in India, right, have, you know, different type of mutations which have been found. So a couple of mutations, which is basically known as E484Q and L425R, which have been found. And this type of the mutation which are found, it's become more infectious, and it is also evading the antibodies which is found in the body. Okay, now this mutations which have individually been found, okay, in several other coronavirus variants have, you know, presence of these both mutations, which is E484Q and L425R, right? And this type of mutations which have been found particularly in India, or particularly from the, you know, from genomes from India. Okay, and there are two already mutations, the mutated genomes have been found in two places, for example, in United Kingdom as well as in South Africa, which have been recognized as the V.1.7. This is basically a variant of coronavirus, which is a mutated form in United Kingdom. In the South Africa, it is known as V.1.351. It is also the mutated form of coronavirus. Okay. Now they have mutations which is associated with the, in these countries, the spikes of coronavirus cases. Okay, a lot of cases which have recently been spiked in those areas. Okay, or in those countries. Now it is also associated with the efficacy of the vaccine. Sometimes what is happening is that the vaccines are not effectively working in those countries also. Okay, which is also the most important aspect. And such type of, you know, the variants which have been found in India, it is also known as the variants of concern. So it is basically the variants of the concern, which is basically found in the mutated form. All right. So this is one such mutated form is also found in India also, as I have given you the name for that. That is V1.1.617. That is the mutated one that is found in India. So far, you can see that global variants of concern related to this coronavirus have been confirmed in the UK. That is UK variant, that is, you know, V1.1.7. So that is V1.1.7. And the South African one, that is V1.351, right? The Brazilian one, that is called P.1, right? And the Indian one, which has been recently recognized, have been known as B.1.617. So that is the Indian one, which has been recognized. So far, the four such variants have been recognized. Okay, next, the muon G-2. It is minus, right? So you can see it is minus. Okay, now I will tell you what is this minus and what is this two indicate. We have found basically the variations or the deviations from the two, that is basically with respect to the muon. So first of all, you have to understand what is this muon and why we are considering this muon, right? So muon is nothing but it is an elementary particle. So when you say muon, the muon is nothing but an elementary particle, okay? Elementary particle means you understand that all building blocks have been made out of muon. So it is the elementary particle that has been found, right? Now, it is similar to the electron, right? With an electric charge of minus E, right? And have a spin of 12. It is just in chemical, you know, when you read the chemistry, you will find that it has, you know, the similarity with respect to the electron, with the electric charge of minus E, okay, minus 1E basically, okay, and it has basically the spin of 12, okay, and but it is having much greater mass than electron, right, and it is also classified at lepton, okay. Now you will be understanding why it is classified in lepton and what is it is lepton is all about. The lepton is also an elementary particle, right, and which is having the half integer spin. The half integer spin means it is having the spin of one half, right? When you read the chemistry, you will understand what is the spin is all about. Okay, so you have the spin with respect to, right, these chemical properties of those particles, right? And that lepton does not undergo any strong interactions. Okay, there are two main classes of the lepton that is existed. First is called charged lepton, right? The charged lepton, which is nothing but the electron-like, right? Which is also known as muons. So muon is one form of lepton. You're getting my point. So I said the lepton is also an elementary particle, which is having the half integer spin. Okay, you understand, right? And these do not undergo any sort of a strong interaction with other particles, okay? When you say the leptons, lepton is also an elementary particle, but these leptons have basically existed in two classes. So first class is called, you know, electron-like lepton. So that have the charge of minus 1e. So that is similar to, or that is also called muon. So muon is a lepton, which is a one class of lepton. Okay. And second is called neutral lepton. Okay. The neutral lepton, which is also known as neutrinos, which does not have charge. Okay, so lepton is two types of classes. One is electron-like. Okay, the second is basically called the neutral lepton. Okay, the neutral lepton, which is also known as the neutrinos. The electron-like, that means it has the charge of minus one electron. Okay, so I hope you understand what is muon and what is lepton. Okay, fine. So let's understand, first of all, the news. So here, the research which is going on with respect to, you know, this subatomic particle, which is also known as muon, right? And which is basically related to the particle physics. All right, I told you it is subatomic particle. So the one branch of physics is known as particle physics, okay? So in the particle physics, right, there is a huge resemblance of these subatomic particles, which are also known as muons or leptons. Now, an experiment which is conducted in the various international laboratories have found that, right, this result, which is basically varied, right, from the experiment which is conducted previously. So that newly published result is basically do not have the match with the predictions of the standard model related to the muon. So the newly published result of the international experiment hint that there is a possibility of new physics, right, which will govern the law of the nature, and ultimately which will govern, you know, the particle physics also. So that study, which is based on these subatomic particles, does not match with the prediction of the standard model. Okay. And what happens is that the prediction of the standard model on which all particle physics is based, if that does not match, obviously we will have to change the basic laws of the nature. Okay. And instead of reconfirming this discrepancy, right, which had been detected around some 20 years back. Okay. So this experiment, which is conducted at the US Department of Energy's Fermi National Accelerator Laboratory, that is also called Fermi Lab. It has been conducted in the USA. Now, let's understand what is the standard model and what it this prediction does not match with the predictions of the standard model. Okay, now the standard model is nothing but a theory or rigorous theory that is basically predict the behavior of these building blocks. The behavior of the building blocks, these building blocks basically are also known as the elementary particles or the muons. Okay, now this basically lays down the six types of, you know, quarks. Now you will be understanding what is this quark. Let's understand first this line, then I will let you know what is quark, what is Higgs boson. Okay, so it basically lays down, or the standard model basically lays down the six different type of quarks, six leptons, or the Higgins boson, which is a fundamental particle, these as well as the three fundamental forces. And it is also says that how these subatomic particles basically behave under the influence of electromagnetic forces. Now let's understand what is this quark and what this standard model gives about six type of quark. So quark is also an elementary particle. Okay, since we are talking only the elementary physics, so we are only concerning with the elementary particles. So this muons, quarks, lepton, they are all elementary particles. So these are elementary particles, okay, but which is having the fundamental constituent of the matter, right? These quarks, which is also an elementary particle, they combine to form a composite particle, right? So when they combine, right, they form basically a composite particle. This composite particle, which is also called hadrons, you are getting my point. And these hadrons are basically most stable, of which are the protons and the neutrons, the component of atomic nuclei. Okay, so that is quark. Leptons, I have told you, the leptons are also, you know, an elementary particles, but which is having the half integer spin. That means the spin is basically half integer. Okay, that is the spin of the lepton, and that does not go strong interactions. And there are two types of leptons, or two class of leptons. One is electron-like, that means which is having the charge of minus 1e. And the second is basically called the neutral lepton, which is also known as the neutrinos. What is Higgs boson? See, Higgs boson, you have heard about the Higgs boson. The Higgs boson is nothing but an elementary particle. It is also an elementary particle since we are dealing with the elementary physics. It is also an elementary particle, right, which is in the use basically in the standard model of particle physics. Obviously, this Higgs boson is produced by the quantum excitation of the Higgs field. So we have found, or we have produced this, the quantum, in the quantum mechanics or quantum physics, you have heard about that quantum, you know, the excitation has led to the formation of this Higgs field, and which is one of the field in the particle physics theory, which we basically used. Okay. So in the standard model, the Higgs particle is basically a massive scalar boson, which is also having the zero spin. Okay. This is having the zero spin and obviously no electric charge. Okay. No electric charge. This is all chemical and the physical properties. Okay. And that also does not have any color, also any color charge. Okay. So you can see that particles like photon that do not interact with it, right? Right. Have no, with left with no mass at all. So you can see all sort of a fundamental fields. The Higgs fields is an associated particle, which is also known as Higgs boson. Okay. So the muon is one such lepton. I've told you that muon is one type of lepton or one class of lepton, right? It is similar to the electron, but it is having 200 times larger. As I told you that the mass is somewhat larger. So as it is 200 times larger. Obviously, the muons are more stable, more unstable, and surviving for a fraction of the second when you compare with the electrons. Okay, let's understand this muon G minus 2 experiment, which is conducted at Fermi Lab in the USA. Okay, so here the measurement basically done as a quantity related to the muon. Okay, which is, you know, also compared with the previous experiment, which is also done by the Brookhaven National Laboratory, which is also in with the US Department of Energy. This experiment, which was concluded in 2001, right? This Brookhaven experiment also came with the results that actually did not match with the predictions by the standard model. Okay. And the muon G minus 2 experiment basically measured this quantity, which has been predicted through this experiment, which is much greater than the accuracy. Okay, now how this or what the quantity is measured? So in that quantity, we call G factor or G minus factor, G minus factor. So that is G minus 2. We are talking about just like G minus 2. So that is muon G minus 2. So G minus 2 is basically the G minus factor. Factor means how this value, which may be 1, 2, 3, 4, or maybe fraction, how this factor is close to the 2. So that is we are trying to measure, right, this in terms of the magnetic properties of the muon. Okay, so how this rate at which the muon bubbles is described by the G factor. Okay, now this quantity is basically measured with the help of this experimental setup. Now obviously, there is, the variations in this G minus factor or the factor. Scientist is basically measuring this deviation from the 2. And hence, this deviation is named as Z minus 2, which is being also associated with the experiment. Now, this new experiment result combined from the Brookhaven as well as recently conducted the Fermi Lab results. Now, in that, the experiment says that the G minus factor is basically, that is been found is basically 00233184122, and analogous magnetic moment that was found is 00116592061. That is just in finding of these two types of experiments, which has been conducted as Brookhaven as well as the Fermi Lab results. Okay, so that is just an indication of the muon G minus 2, variations. Okay, next. The tribunal reforms, rationalization and conditions of the service ordinance 2021. Now you have seen that the government of India is basically trying to, basically abolishing the appellate tribunals. These appellate tribunals are basically set up, right, with, to listen all sort of the orders which have been given by the normal tribunals. So these appellate tribunals will hear the appeals which have been brought before them as a result of the verdict which have been given by the tribunals. So based on this ordinance, the government of India has abolished the film certificate appellate tribunal. Okay, this film certificate appellate tribunal basically here the appeals from the the body called CVFC. Okay, so that basically hears the demand from Central Board of Film Certification, that is a statutory body. Okay, so instead of now this film certification appellate tribunals, if the Central Board of Film Certification, right, have stayed down the particular release of the film, then producers have to approach directly to the High Court. They cannot approach now to the Film Certification Appellate Tribunal. Now this Film Certificate Appellate Tribunal have now been completely abolished. That means now the film producers, they have to approach directly against the order which is given by the Central Board of Film Certification directly to the High Court. They cannot move to the, the film certification at appellate tribunal, which have been recently been abolished by the government of India. Now, this tribunal reform, rationalization and conditions of the service ordinance came into effect from April 4. Okay, that is basically, amending this Cinematograph Act 1952. Okay, that is basically, omitting certain sections as well as replacing certain sections. For example, instead of word tribunal now, which is also referred to the Film Certificate Appellate Tribunal, this tribunal have been replaced with the High Court. So you can see that now instead of the order of the Central Board of Film Certification, the producers or the filmmakers, now they have to move to the High Court directly because there is no such film certificate appellate tribunal, right? And the abolition of this, you know, will now have to approach directly, you know, to the High Court whenever they want to challenge any order given by the Central Board of Film Certification. Okay, so that's all. Next, the Government Securities Acquisition Program, that is also called GSAP. Now, this Government Securities Acquisition Program is basically, is basically carried out by the Reserve Bank of India. So RBI Governor has announced this acquisition program, right, through which the Reserve Bank of India will purchase the government securities. Okay, generally, that is what is happening. And the RBI will purchase around government security of 1 lakh crore rupees in the first quarter of financial year 2020. Okay, now it is happening because of, in the backdrop of the government high borrowing for this year, the elevated borrowing this year. Now, the RBI also ensured that without any causes of the disruption, the securities acquisition program will be carried out smoothly, and so that it will also be comfort to the bond market in our country, right? Now, here the market participants always wanted to know about RBI's open market operations purchase calendar. So that is, now RBI will provide through this announcement, that is the government securities acquisition program. Now, what is this open market operations? So in the open market operations, what is that? See, open market operations is nothing but refers to the central bank or RBI, you know, buy or sell the short-term treasury, right? Or the securities basically in the open market, right? Why this Reserve Bank of India basically buy or sell this short-term treasury or the security in the open market? Because the RBI will try to influence through this measure the money supply in the market. Okay, and obviously the RBI also influenced the short-term interest rate with the help of this open market operation. Now, this open market operations is nothing but it's a stimulus sale and the purchase of the government securities and the treasury bills that is done by the RBI. The objective of this open market operations is to regulate the money supply in the market. I hope you are getting my point. Okay, so in order to regulate this money supply in the economy, the RBI generally conduct the open market operations. Now, the most important point to be noted here is that this open market operations, which is carried out by the RBI, right, only through commercial banks, that means selling and buying of the government securities and the treasury bills, that is only from and through the commercial banks. Okay, and RBI does not directly deal with the public. That is the most important point. RBI does not deal directly with the public. It is done through, basically through the commercial banks. Okay, so obviously this move would certainly, to the bond market participants, right? With regard to, the RBI commitment to the bond market with respect to this financial year 2022. Okay, it will basically a structured program that is basically control some sort of a money supply interest rates. Okay, and it will also reduce the spread between, reduce the spread between the repo rate and the 10 years government bond yield. So that is also linked with that open market operations. And obviously that will also reduce the government cost of borrowing for the center as well as for the states. Okay, next, net zero goal. Now you must understand the net zero goal is also referred to the carbon neutrality. The carbon neutrality. What is this carbon neutrality? The carbon neutrality is nothing but, you must understand, it is not that the country is just emitting zero emissions. No, it is nothing like countries emitting zero emissions. No, carbon neutrality is something that the country's emissions, whatever the emissions of, which has been released by the country. Now these emissions are compensated by either absorption of these emissions or the removal of these greenhouse gases from the atmosphere. So you need some sort of a technological advancement, or you need some sort of a other methods by which you can absorb these greenhouse gases, or you can remove these greenhouse gases. So that is called carbon neutrality. Now this net zero goal, right, which is also pledging that, that by 2050, right? Every country will have this 2050 net zero goal, that is the carbon neutrality. So in that backdrop, the US president's special envoy on the climate, that is John Kerry, recently visited India on the 3-day visit, okay? And the John Kerry will basically discuss and explore the possibilities whether the India can also agree with the possibility of pledging this zero net zero goal, that is by 2050, the government of India has to ensure that the India will be carbon neutral country by 2050, right? So it is basically just bringing down, you know, the emissions, you know, with the help of the absorption, removal of the greenhouse gases. So that is the carbon neutrality. That is, you know, that is offsetting with the help of the absorption and the removal. Okay, that is there. So here, rather than this net zero, right, which is, you know, which is very important. Now, this is basically compensated by the absorption as well as with the removal of greenhouse gases. Now, obviously, how will you absorb these emissions? Obviously, you have to increase more carbon sinks. Carbon sinks, basically, those can sink this added carbon in the atmosphere. How would you ensure? You would ensure with the help of more forestation. So you have to grow more forest. Okay. And you will have to rely on the futuristic technology, right? You have like carbon storage, carbon capture, right? Which is also the futuristic technology and which will be also the most important aspect of this absorption of the carbon from the atmosphere. Okay. Now, in this way, it is possible that every country will have the negative emissions, right? Because the country will be trying to absorb as much as the emissions from the atmosphere, as well as this removal is basically, you know, exceeded the addition or the actual emissions which has been emitted out from the particular country. So that is the negative emissions. And Bhutan is one such classic example, which is a carbon negative country, or which is a carbon negative country. So which absorb more gases or more greenhouse gases than actually what it is releasing or emitting. So Bhutan is a carbon negative, and we can basically take, you know, the inspiration from the Bhutan to also make the India as a carbon negative country. Now, what is the significance of net zero goal by 2050? Now, you must understand there is a huge significance because our climate is changing very drastically. The weather is changing. Okay, we are facing, you know, the high amount of heat. Now, all ecosystems are basically getting disturbed because of the temperature rise, because of the ecosystem imbalances, right? So obviously that will have, you know, the greater impact on every sections of the world. So the India also should take it seriously to make it the net zero goal for 2050. Now, how would you achieve this Paris Agreement, right? The Paris Agreement deals with that the temperature of the planet should not be rising beyond 2 degrees Celsius. As we compare with the pre-industrial time. So that is the goal of the Paris Agreement. If you want to confirm, if you want to stick to the Paris Agreement target, you will have to have this net zero goal for 2050, that is carbon neutrality by 2050 for every country. Okay, and the current policies across the world, okay, if that continues, obviously that will not prevent the 3 to 4 degree rise of the temperature by the end of this century. So that will be, you know, that will be providing very drastic and the negative results on the basically, the climate change, as well as it will impact, you know, various other, the ecosystems negatively. So it will be highly, you know, influential or highly impactful in terms of the negativity to the world, right? Because it will deplete all sort of the glaciers, right? It will also, affect the human's health also, because the sea level will ultimately rise. There will be haphazard, you know, the climatic variations, all sort of things basically negatively impact the anthropogenic also. Okay. Next, the civil defense volunteers. Now you must understand these civil defense volunteers are basically, you know, basically have been taken to cater to the need of the society. Now, these civil defense volunteers are basically, you know, are found in every, in the state, that is basically helping, you know, the civil society, right? So these civil defense volunteers are basically involved in various works. For example, now the coronavirus, they have been involved in, right, in the execution of or in the enforcement of certain regulations, rules with respect to this coronavirus lockdown. Okay, so they have been lauded for their work during the pandemic. So they have done very seriously their work during the pandemic, as well as they are also facing certain allegations also of the high-endedness. Okay, and this issue have become very intense because of their high-endedness. And you must also understand they are also having the khaki uniform. This is looks identical with the police also. Now it is very difficult for the persons to identify them, right? Whether it is the police or the civil defense personnel, right? And which is ultimately led to the high-endedness or by those civil defense volunteers sometime. And it is also comes in the purview of the public. The Delhi police very recently have clarified many times also that the civil defense personnel are also known as Delhi civil defense, that is DCD. There is also, you know, in their uniform also, it is written that DCD. You can also read it. Okay. They are simply civil defense personnel and they have no power to stop the people. They cannot stop the people. Okay. They cannot put police barricades. Okay. They cannot prosecute the people. Right. Even if the person is violating to some sort of a COVID-19, you know, rules and regulation, they cannot prosecute the person. So such powers are not there. Okay, the powers are lies with the police. So that is one thing. They are just helping the police as well as the civil society for mitigating that type of challenge which have been come out from the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, so you can see here, these people are basically the civil defense volunteers. Okay, next, the India Seychelles relations. Okay, the Seychelles, as you know, it is an island country in our Indian Ocean. Okay, and India is basically having a friendly relationship with the Seychelles. Now the Prime Minister Narendra Modi as well as the Seychelles president jointly inaugurate several Indian projects in the Seychelles. Now it has been done virtually because now the coronavirus pandemic has stopped every such things. Okay, now the Prime Minister Narendra Modi also says that the Seychelles is central to the India's vision of the Sagar. The Sagar is nothing but the security and the growth for all in the region. So what is this Sagar? Let's understand this Sagar. The Sagar is nothing but it is the India's policy, right? Or a doctrine of maritime cooperation in the Indian Ocean region. So it is a doctrine where the maritime cooperation in the Indian Ocean region is done. So this policy was first announced by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi on March 2015. So this policy was announced, and India has have the friendly relations with the Seychelles. So during the time of need, even the pandemic, the India has supplied the essential medicines to the Seychelles, as well as 50,000 doses of the coronavirus vaccine have also been supplied to the Seychelles, which is made in India. Okay, and it is the first African country to receive the made in India COVID-19 vaccine. So this is also most important. Okay, and India is also contributing towards, the new building which is being constructed in the Seychelles, which is related to the magistrate court. Okay, so India has contributed to the construction of this magistrate court. And India has also handed over to the Seychelles the fast patrol vessels to the Seychelles. Okay, which is basically the made in India, obviously to the Seychelles Coast Guard to enhancing the maritime, security specifically in the region. Now, India also handed over the 1 megawatt solar power plant to the Seychelles, which is being built with the Indian assistance. So India is a friendly country with the Seychelles, and which is also, the most important aspect between the friendly, between India and the Seychelles, as well as their friendly relations. Okay. This virtual summit between the two sides also saw the handing over of 10 high impact community development projects. This high impact community development project is implemented by the High Commission of India in the Seychelles, and it has been implemented with the collaboration of the local bodies, educational and the vocational institutions at the local level. Okay, so this community development projects basically help in the community to deal with certain exigencies because of some sort of a coronavirus pandemic or other problems. Okay, so you can see here it is an Indian Ocean, the Seychelles, which is basically an island country. Okay, Next, the copyright amendment rules 2021. Now you must understand, this copyright amendment rules have been recently been notified by the government of India. Okay, copyright everybody knows. Okay, now India's copyright rules and copyright designs is basically governed by the Copyright Act 1957, which have been passed by the parliament of this country. And now the associated rules related to the Copyright Act is basically given by the government of India in 2013. That is called Copyright Rules 2013. These been recently been amended in 2016. Okay, and obviously, you know, this rules is basically try to bring all sort of existing rules and the procedures with the parity of other relevant legislations, as well as to confirm the international rules and regulations. Okay, now the provision basically regarding to the publication of the copyright general have been incorporated. Now this is basically, you know, with the publication of this copyright general basically eliminate the requirement of this publication in the official gazette. Now there is no requirement of this publication in the official gazette. Okay, and this said general, which is basically known as the publication of copyright general, will be available at the website of the copyright office. Okay, now in order to further boost this transparency and accountability, okay, now there have been several provisions have also been introduced, right? For example, you know, to deal with undistributed royalty amount and also to use of electronic and the traceable payment method while collecting or distributing any sort of a royalties among the copyright holders. Okay. And, you know, to reinforce further the accountability and the transparency, the working of the copyright societies have also been reformed. So a new rule have been introduced whereby these copyright societies will be required to draw up and make an annual transparency report, right? This annual transparency report for every financial year will allow or will enhance the transparency in their procedure and their functioning, as well as will also boost the accountability of such copyright societies. Okay, and such amendment is basically with the harmonized with the copyright rules that will basically also harmonization with the Finance Act 2017. Okay, and this copyright board have been recently been merged with the appellate board for better governance as well as for better transparency and accountability measures. Okay, and this compliance of the requirement of the registration of the software, okay, now this compliance have been reduced. Now the applicant, which is basically registering for this copyright, now they have liberty to file first 10 or last 10 pages of the source code. They can just leave other one. So just file or, you know, first page or first 10 page or last 10 pages, or they can also file entire source code, right? If it is consisting of less than 20 page. Okay. Obviously they will have to ensure that there is no blocked out or no redacted portions in that particular file. Okay. And the time limit for the central government for responding to such applications have been increased. So that is extended to 180 days. Now, why it is extended to 180 days? To ensure that the applications can be more comprehensively examined by the central government. So that is how certain changes or certain amendment which have also been carried out. Okay, to ensure that the central government will have the more time to exhaustively review such type of applications. Next, the Indian National Young Academy of Science. You know, the Indian National Young Academy of Science is the scientist academy or is the young scientist academy of India, first of all. Now, the idea of setting up of this Indian National Young Academy of Sciences is basically the awareness to generate the awareness programs specifically in the field of science. So the INEAS or Indian National Young Academy of Science launched a multi-pronged nationwide mass awareness campaign, obviously, to bust the myth about this COVID-19 vaccination program. Many people are basically skeptical of taking the vaccine of the COVID-19 because they feel that such vaccine will have the side effect or adverse impact on the health impacts or health related matters. So to bust that, you know, the myth, this multi-pronged nationwide mass awareness campaign have been launched. Now this campaign have been launched or carried out through the COVAC News Android mobile based app. So you can also download this app from the Play Store, where all sort of awareness related campaign to bust this, you know, myth about this COVID-19 vaccination have been done away with. Now, this India National Young Academy of Science is the first and only recognized Young Scientist Academy of India. Okay. The Indian INAS basically is founded by Indian National Science Academy Council in 2014. The main purpose of setting of this INAS is to promote the science education, and it will be promoting through the networking among the young scientists at the national level as well as at the international level. Okay. Next, drones, you know, they are also called unmanned aerial vehicles, okay, which has been remotely operated. Okay. So there is nothing like pilot inside it. It has been remotely operated from the ground station. Okay. Recently, the drone use have been given permission to the Central Mine Planning Design Institute for doing the coal field survey in India. Okay. So the Ministry of Civil Aviation as well as the Directorate General of Civil Aviation have been granting the conditional exemption to the Central Mine Planning and the Design Institute, right? Which is a premier, you know, institute of the government of India for the purpose of the mine planning as well as for the purpose of exploration of, you know, certain, you know, the minerals. So that institute will carry out the surveying in the coal field areas, okay, which is basically belongs to the Coal India Limited. So as per the conditional exemption which has been provided, right, these drones, which is also called unmanned aerial vehicles, will be deployed for the acquisition of this data. Okay, this data will be captured for monitoring purpose of the mapping as well as for doing the surveying activities, right? It is being done through the unmanned aerial vehicles based optical lidar, the thermal payloads, the volumetric measurements, as well as the inspections will be carried out in the coal field areas of the Coal India Limited. So these unmanned aerial vehicles will be doing this mapping, surveying activities, right, with the help of this lidar and UAV based optical and thermal payloads. It will also do the volumetric measurements as well as the inspections in the Coal India, you know, the mines in the coal field areas. Okay, this conditional exemption is valid till 4th of April 2022. Okay, it will be, you know, valid from the date of issue of the letter or, you know, until the full operationalization of digital sky platform, that is a phase one which is underway, whichever is earlier, right? So either if this, you know, the operationalization of digital sky platform phase one is got over, or the 4th of April, which is the cutoff date or which the last date up to which the exemption is given, whichever is earlier, the exemption will be valid. Okay, the exemption which has been given by the Ministry of Civil Aviation must be obtained from, you know, from the US rules, you know, before such operation is to be carried out. Okay, you can see this is a drone which is also used, you know, for the various purposes around the world. Recently, this exemption have been granted to, you know, to the institute for carrying out the survey as well as other prospecting activities related to the mining areas belongs to the Coal India Limited. All right. So that's all. Thank you for today. We will meet tomorrow for our next current affairs. Thank you.